biggest down the rabbit hole.
We got like 8 minutes left before we hit our 30-minute mark. We got two teams left.
Okay.
Utah State Aggies. 11-2 last year, 7-1. Fantastic. Love this team. Two offensive starters back. That's it. And then seven on defense. Number 11 most experienced in the Mountain West. Number 124 in the country.
That's the only reason I got the record I got is because they're just turning over too many people.
Yeah, it's a lot of people. Head coach Matt Wells, he is now at Texas Tech. So the brass decided to pick up a former coach.
This is another reason why I have him regressing a little bit.
Gary Anderson. Wells left basically no experience behind. No. I mean, it's...
he said, oh, somebody's going to hire me now? Perfect time to take that job.
Yeah. And it's... Now, I will say this. Quarterback Jordan Love?
Oh, no, yeah.
He's back, and he is a friggin' superstar.
When you don't have to replace the quarterback, it does help hide the transition between a new coaching staff. I think he's smart. I think he pick up a new system if they run a new thing. If they run the old
thing. And I don't think they're going to change a whole lot on it. 3,500 plus yards on offense, 39 touchdowns. So that's 32 passing and seven rushing. Look, they lose four out of five offensive line starters, their top three wide receivers, their top running back and tight end, both left early for the NFL draft. The defense returns a lot of experience in the front seven, but only one starter back in the secondary. Offense probably regresses a little bit because they were the number two scoring offense in the country last year.
That's going backwards.
The defense should improve under Anderson. They were number 51 in total D in 2018. Anderson's bread and butter is defense. The schedule is insanely more difficult this year than it was last year. I think they've still got guys. I think that Gary Anderson can coach. I've got them at 7-5 this year. I got them 5-3 in the conference.
I've got them even better than you. You got them more. I've got them 8-4.
8-4. Now here's where I am. Okay, a loss at Wake Forest, a win over Stony Brook, a loss at San Diego State, a win over Colorado State, a loss at LSU. So that's 2-3 to open. Then I've got a loss to Nevada at home, a win at Air Force, a win against BYU at home, at Fresno State. I've got them losing. And then I've got them beating Wyoming, Boise, and at New Mexico at the end of the year. Like, that is a murderer's row there. And I've got them winning some, losing some. I think 7-5 would be a really good season for a team that is number 124 in the country in experience returning.
True. True.
That's it. You know another team that was like this that we just saw fall apart last year? Florida Atlantic.
Oh yeah, they went
where they had like a lot of experience coming back, right. Superstar quarterback, all this kind of mess.
Had a great season.
Yep, went 11-2 last year, and then lost everybody. But everybody still thinks, oh well, they got a few key pieces back, and Lane Kiffin will figure out what to do. Well, you lose that much experience, and when the schedule toughens up,
yeah, I might be too high.
So I mean, 8-4, like it's totally reasonable. I just think, you know, at 7-5, 8-4, there's not a big difference there.
No,